Hey everyone, this is Dr. Kazi, and in this video, we are going to study about the cubital fossa, the contents of the cubital fossa, and the boundaries of the cubital fossa. Now, this topic is very, very important according to the examination point of view. So you should focus on this one. We know that upper limb is divided into seven main regions, starting with the shoulder, which consists of your clavicle bone, and the scapula. Then in the arm region, we have the humerus bone, the elbow, which connects your arm with the forearm. Now in the forearm, we have two important bones, the radius bone and the ulna bone. In the hands, we have the carpal bones and the metacarpal bones in the hand and wrist. Now, the elbow is connecting your arm with the forearm. In front of this elbow, you have a triangular depression. This triangular depression is known as the cubital fossa. Now, have a look at this diagram. Fold up your sleeves and look for yourself. In front of your elbow joint, you have this triangular depression. This is the cubital fossa. Its content and its boundaries are very, very important clinically. Now, let's talk about the contents of the cubital fossa. It includes medial nerve, the brachial vessels, which include the brachial arteries and the veins, the biceps tendons, and the radial nerve. Now the question is, how will you remember these contents? You can remember by revising it with the help of this mnemonic, MBBS. Now, M stands for the median nerve, B for the brachial vessels, B for the biceps tendon, and S for the superficial radial nerve. Now, let's have a look at the median nerve. Now, remember, median nerve is on the medial side of your elbow joint. Now, if I look from the medial to the lateral side, I will have the median nerve, the brachial vessels, the biceps tendons, and the radial nerve. This is the lateral side, and this is the medial side. So you can remember with the help of this mnemonic, MBBS. Now, the boundaries is also very important. The boundaries consist of the muscles and the bones. Now, two important muscles are present on the medial side and the lateral side. Have a look at this diagram. On the lateral side, we have brachioradialis muscle. And on the medial side, we have the pronator teres muscle. The base of the cubital fossa is formed by a line which is joining the two epicondyles of this humerus bone right here. Now, let's talk about the floor and the roof of the cubital fossa. The floor is formed by two other muscles. I cannot show the floor muscles in this diagram, but you can imagine they are beneath these two muscles, the brachioradialis and the pronator teres. The floor muscles are supinator and the brachialis. Now, the roof is formed by none other than your skin. This was all about the contents and the boundaries of cubital fossa. Please do like, share, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.